And hello, you awesome people. How the heck are you down here in Socher, Mississippi at the old P.O.W. Prisoner of War camp? And now it's turned into a recreational camping area. Back in World War II, actually held Nazi prisoners of war out here. There's not much left. There's a few bunkers up ahead, and I'll show you with that later, but listen to that. Whole lot of nothing. I love it out here. So what I come out here to do is make a what is called a Dakota camp, Dakota pit fire, or Dakota campfire. And it's an interesting idea. You dig two holes about the same depth apart. This here is gonna where I burn the wood. And then this one is where the air will come into. And how will the air get from this pit to this pit is... that hole there. The idea is when the flames start going up, it'll suck the oxygen into that hole underground through the other pit. And I gotta be honest with you, why anybody would do this, because it took a long time to dig these two holes, because this is clay, really tough clay. It'd been a lot easier if the ground had a different soil content, but it was absolute murder digging through this. It took me about an hour and a half with the post hole diggers and a little shovel and a big shovel. So other than that, and I do have a little charcoal in there. I just want to test this out. I'm actually going to cook something on there to show it to you. So let me put this camera up on the tripod and we'll get this fire rolling. Next time I'm going to bring my fishing pole. Love it out here. So now what we're going to do is take all the bundles of semi-dry pine twigs and stuff like that. Again, I've cheated. I do have some charcoal down in there, but, you know, that's how I roll. Actually, the fire pit may be too deep. But, you know what? We'll roll with it. Because I have... if this goes right, ha ha ha. I'm going to cook some larger pieces of wood on here. Now, from what I understand, these fires like this are not to keep warm. They're just for cooking on. From what I've heard and seen on YouTube. But, you know what? We're going to test that and see if we can't do both. I mean, what's to say when you have the fire started, you can cook here. Then on top of the fire, you can put a couple of big logs on there. Now I was wondering how I was going to cook on that open pit without... man, there's nowhere to set the pan. So what do you do? Well, it's starting to rain. I should generate enough heat to start the meal cooking. When you're out camping, what do you cook? Chili with beans. Getting the smoke in the eye. And this is really a lot to go through just to cook some food. My preference style of camping is not having to dig two holes. It takes an hour or whatever. But you know what? There's nothing else to do. And it's a nice day. About to get some rain. Well, you know what? I'm gonna cheat a little bit because I can. This little piece of grill I keep in the back of the truck. And that's why I keep it in the back of the truck. You never know what you're gonna need. I keep everything for camping. I have a lot of stuff in my pickup truck for camping. Again, this is an interesting way to cook food. Again, personally, it's just way too much trouble and effort to go through. There's just a lot of simpler ways to do it. It's a lot easier to make just a regular fire so that you can keep warm and cook at the same time. So if you know why, the reason to build a fire like this, because I've heard people call it a stealth fire so it won't smoke, or just all kinds of other reasons, but I don't know. It's just, for me, a complete waste of time. But, well, I shouldn't say a waste of time. It's nice to get outside and enjoy, again, this scenery. Thank you.